Live. That was the good shit. Oh, all right, let's start training another person. I'll figure out later who this is gonna be, but we need a specialist. The curse of the specialists. A mass grave, huh? Cool. Well, let's keep getting these supplies from this fucking stadium. New course. How many days do we have? 13 days until the supply drop. And only 30 supplies in pocket.
Strategic resource located.
Well, now we have more supplies, not a ton, but more. And we should be having the number of days that it takes to scan at a location. So I guess these are all originally 12-day scans. That's a lot. Oh no, because we didn't reach that bonus. That's right. Okay, whoever that is our new specialist. And let's start training another grenadier too. Since Quetz has gone the way of the dodo. Literally, his species is extinct. Whoops, what am I doing here? Grenadier? One more day to the Shadow Chamber. It's pretty good.
Shadow Chamber now operational.
Although I'm impressed with the strides we've made in infiltrating the alien psionic network, the depths of their technological advancement continue to leave us one step behind. However, with the enhanced decryption capabilities of this chamber, I'm confident we will find a great deal more information than we had previously hoped.
New objective added.
Nice.
New objective added.
Nice!
We are fully prepared to begin our analysis of the material recovered from the Advent Black Site, Commander. With the Shadow Chamber fully operational, we can use its advanced decryption capabilities to analyze the Codex artifact recovered by our forces.
And our HQ music has changed, because we built the Shadow Chamber. We've got a workshop gremlin we can do something with. Oh, let's throw them in the Proving Grounds. We should be working on a Proving Ground project, because we have two more cores. What are we doing? What are we doing? What will we do? I vote that we do experimental ammo. Nearly anything will be useful here. We're probably going to give whatever the experimental ammo is that we get, we're probably going to give it to one of our snipers, I'm guessing. But anyway, let's do that.
Interesting choice. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
So actually, we have three cores total, two more on top of that. Okay, keep searching the cave. We want that sweet loot.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Brilliant. Finally. We've recovered enough of the Advent armor to begin repurposing the outer plates, into something better suited to our soldiers. The material seems to be the same as what the aliens utilized throughout the Avengers Hull, an extremely durable substance with an unusual ambient magnetic property. As an armor component, the magnetic field surrounding these plates will actually provide additional protection against magnetic-based weaponry, most notably the Gauss weaponry. Gauss, commonly equipped by Advent. Excellent. So, we can build a better frame for Seabass. Sorry, I'm clearing my throat so much. We can build a predator armor, we can build a spider suit, and we can build an exo suit. Of all the stuff we could do here, 5 days for mutant autopsy. I'm tempted to say we do the mutant autopsy now.
Central Officer Bradford has personally substantiated claims that the massive frontline unit they call the Muton was actually at one time even larger than the specimen I have before me today. As it is, the creature is abnormally warm to the touch for a corpse, and I must say, it is quite disconcerting.
A Excellent.
Maybe we should start training someone else to pilot the Avenger. I'm never going to get any work done if Mr. Bradford can't keep the ship steady.
Fly straight, Bradford. Don't fuck up. Okay, what do we got in the armory? We have 3 days, 2 days wounded, 6 days wounded for Seabass, but that's not going to help. I mean, nobody in the Advanced Warfare Center is going to be able to help with that. Let's finish up in the cave. Ooh, I like this image. The many large caves found in this region contributed to rumors that the original XCOM headquarters was once found here. While exploring, we did find the weathered remains of both human and alien artifact abandoned since the invasion. And after a few hours underground, our team successfully returned with a number of alien materials. Nice. I'd love to have that extra stuff. How are we doing? So we're three pips away from another end-of-the-world type scenario. We have a three-pip facility here and a one-pip facility here, and we have one resistance contact still available to us with certainly enough intel. We only need 80 and 40, respectively, to make contact. We could spend our time getting alien alloys. I wish we have 100. So we have a lot of alien alloys, though. When was the last time we went to the black market? I don't know if we know.
Market is open.
Or that we've sold everything we can. We can sell more officers and more shield bearers. Meh. Sure. It's not really amazing stuff. We'll just hold on to the officers. We'll hold on to everything for now. I don't think we need to sell anything like this. Yeah, let's just hold on to all of this stuff. Oh, and what are they... whoops, what do they got for sale? We can rush research on some stuff that nobody really cares about. We can buy an engineer. Buy an advanced repeater. Buying Illyrium is tempting for only 35 intel. That's pretty good, actually. Let's do that. Because, again, we'll need that later. And let's head to... Resistance HQ.
For the East African sector.
And see if they can sell us a soldier. I gotta keep in mind we also need money for
welcome, Commander.
Armor, but they have no soldiers for sale. So let's just hit the. We got a lot of alien allies. I don't know. Let's just. Yeah, let's start making contact with West Asia.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
I hear you.
Attempting to establish local regional contacts.
Okay.
Commander, we've had the Shadow Chamber running the numbers. These are the tactical projections for our next field operation.
Fuck. Codex, Viper Serpens, Advanced Assault, Advanced Heavy, Fire Starter, and Mutons. And we have to defend the Resistance Haven. Okay. Let's see how much money it costs to build armor.
New orders, Commander?
New orders? Never. Okay. Armor. Predator is 150 supplies, and reinforced frame is 100 supplies. So all told, we need about 150 supplies if we want to buy both of these. Ugh.
Pickings are slim, but I'm hoping we find a few more recruits who can handle a wrench. I could use the help.
Okay, let's see how many supplies we can get from sales. Soupy sales.
Mm-hmm. Avenger plotting new course.
Market is open.
So, lockboxes. I know we got a ton of lockboxes, and they're always worth a bunch of money. We got a strongbox, too. Yeah, we'll sell a strongbox. We'll sell a couple lockboxes. We're already up to 125. What can we get rid of? We have a ton of chrysalid corpses here. And this should give us all the money that we need. Love those lockboxes and reliquaries.
What can I do for you, Commander?
You can build the stuff that will help to keep us living. 6 trooper corpses are required there. 5 Illyrium crystals. That's interesting.
The aptly named Predator armor should give our soldiers increased longevity in the field.
I don't know if I like Seahorse having, like, a robot arm and halo armor. We'll probably change that. And let's get this reinforced frame, too. Okay, and now we have 1 supplies, which is great. Okay. Let's head to the Resistance Haven.
Setting course for Eastern Europe.
Game's having a little trouble here. Let's, actually, let's save real quick and I'll outfit everybody more appropriately and then we'll come back. Heya, hiya, hiya. I got distracted yesterday and, well, you don't know what yesterday is. Yesterday was the first... What you just watched was yesterday. What you're watching now is today. So I've been dreading having to do this Resistance Haven defense, but we're gonna do it. Off-screen, I went and sold a little more stuff with the black market, so we can give our guys some more stuff. I made medikit, EMP grenade, and another flashbang. I don't know who we're gonna give all this shit to, to be honest. 1 grenade per soldier, huh? I forgot about the whole 1 grenade per soldier thing. Because now we have Predator armor, we have 2 slots. That's the whole deal there. How do we want to do this? Maybe I'll give Grum the medikit. It's not gonna. I mean, it's basically in case somebody gets poisoned and are gonna die, or get set on fire and are gonna die. Something really intense like that. If I give somebody an EMP grenade, that means they lose the regular grenade. And I'm tempted to make that Dan Hench. The new Dan Hench. I can't remember if I introduced people last time. I hope I did. No way of knowing. And we'll give the second flashbang to Trenchfoot, because we're probably going to run into more than enemies to Typhoon Codex. We're going to run into more than 1 Codex. So there's no way that we can know the things are going to be, you know, good. Plus, at least, let me actually save again now that I did all this shit. Alright, let's go. Let's get in there. Let's do it now. Do it now! No time like the horrible present.
Deployed.
What? Okay, that's okay. Good time to let me know, Bradford.
In position to drop.
Remote reconnaissance picked up heavy comms traffic from alien forces moving to attack a resistance outpost in this region, and we're the only ones with any chance of stopping them. We're heading in to lock down the area. Neutralize all hostile contacts with extreme prejudice. Menace 1-5, hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot, so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Oh, I don't like this already. There's some nice elevated positions over on this side. I love that really high roof, actually. I think our best chance of survival is to try to make our way over there, although there's this big, deadly field in the way. And I can practically promise that's not going to go great. Alright, where's our Grum? As always, in the back to start. In the absolute worst place he could be. Thanks, Grum! Let's have you scout ahead.
Moving on target location.
We've got to survive for 12 turns. That's all we got
to
do.
The Resistance has done everything it can to convince people to join the cause. But it's an uphill battle when you've got Advent whispering propaganda in your ear 24 hours a day.
Yeah, and raining down hell on the resistance camps.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Okay. Well, I feel more comfortable moving up at least. So, go ahead, DDT.
I'll take care of it.
We've got... Who we got? We got the clone of Kawhi AC guy here with us. That's cool.
Not a problem.
We've also got the clone of ZC. A little sneezy. How you doing, ZC? Let's move some other people first, because they're all kind of in the way. And Dan Henge will move you up as well. I'm not too worried about keeping everybody exactly in cover while we're concealed. You can laugh when that becomes my undoing.
I'm going.
Seabass.
New options.
New options. New modalities. What do we got here? Oh, right, ZC. Go ahead, ZC.
Right. I'm on my way.
Right, I forgot that ZC has the Jensen voice pack. Butler side sure and Seahorse.
Right.
Let's just make our way up. We, you know, time is sort of on our side, except that the reinforcement drops are going to come at regular intervals. And if we don't take out at least one pod, here they come, before the reinforcement drops arrive. Oh, wow, two nails. That's good. Ooh, except there's a codex there. Ah, best part about a codex pod being triggered is that the codex doesn't run, usually. The codex teleports, so that means they won't trigger overwatch fire, and therefore will not clone
Commander,
themselves.
The situation just got worse. Resistance outposts are reporting enemy transports on the move across this region. They're getting ready for an all-out assault.
I gotta say, though, it makes a lot of sense to me that they would be right clustered around this area I want to be in. These fucking trees in the way, man. I can't see shit. Okay, we got a lot of advent, which means... kind of, I don't want to say no time like the present, but there kind of is no time like the present as far as DDT using poison grenade. So,
on my way.
Get up there, hopefully don't trigger any pods on your way. Good. And then, give these guys something to breathe about.
Grenade out!
Yeah, that was good, that was a good line. Let's give them something to breathe about, something to breathe, a little something inside their lungs. Nice! That killed one of the assaults. The other two are poisoned. They got some shred on there. Okay. Good start. If we can... There's no way that you can grapple up to here. No, you're way too far away for that. It would have been so good, though. You can grapple up to here. Ooh, that's tempting. Very tempting.
I'll take the high road.
Nice! And you got a flank shot on the codex. Yeah, codex. Can you throw... No, there's no way you can throw a grenade, like, around the wall, right? That would just be too good. Oh, wait. Through the tarmac? Or the tarp? Not tarmac, Jesus Christ. There's, like, a little spot here. Come on, there... dip! Oh, content! I know y'all love the content. Come on. Come on, little one. Oh, this is useless. If we bring Seahorse here, she'll be behind low cover, but she should get flanking shot on the codex, a rapid fire flanking shot. She'll be at a distance, though, so it's not exactly a guaranteed shot. If she's here, she should also get the flanking shot. That's full cover, and it's a little closer. I like that better. Let's do that. Get her up there. Rune and gun, Seahorse, get in on the shit. We want to take this codex down if we can, and we don't want to use flashbang if we can get away with it. Sundere is taking away 10% because you don't like people, Seahorse. That's really good. But you are a small town person, so that's giving you plus 10%. I guess this is a small town. Oh, beautiful. You didn't even need the second shot.
All right.
So we still have a flashbang in our repertoire that we didn't have to use. That's great. Repertoire. Alright, Trenchfoot, what can you do? Not a whole lot. You can suppress people, though, if it comes to that. And it may, because we're not getting good shots here. Except... Seabass, yeah, you're still not getting good shots. Seabass starts with minus one health. Oh well. But he's got a pretty good shot on the Advanced Soldier. Ooh, if he can hit the Advanced Heavy, though, that's way better. The Advanced Soldier may just die in the next turn from poison. Beautiful!
Listen to the sounds of your own extinction.
Awesome. Awesome! Okay. Bring up Dan Edge. There's more to this pod that we're not seeing. They're like hidden or something, so we're gonna have to set Overwatch traps as well. CC, you can move up behind this cover. And you will definitely go on Overwatch, so you can't hit anything. Butler side, you are the Overwatch king. What? Did you just speak a voice? What voice do you have right now? Your voice pack is supposed to be Japanese.
Affirmative, covering now.
What the fuck is that? What happened to your voice? Alright, that's gotta get fixed. Kawaii, clone of Kawaii. If you're not, that looks like you've got the cool armor on, but you don't.
I'm on it.
Ugh. Alright, yeah, just everybody, should you steady weapon, or... let's just have you go on Overwatch. We need a lot of Overwatch firepower right now. What have you got? You got an EMP. Oh, you also have the Skulljack. That's good.
Affirmative, covering now!
Yeah.
Got it covered.
And, I guess Grum going Overwatch. He's not going to do anything. Unless he gets spotted. Oh yeah, he died. That poison is... that's nasty stuff. Well, we know the poison's nasty stuff. We had poison on us. Last mission. That went really well. I hear a snake. I see a berserker. That's our second pod. Nail him! Nail him! Yeah! Oh, that was good!
That armor's tough!
I mean, yes, it is, but that was a good hit. Okay, another rather heavily organic pod. Damn! Okay, good. Quiet. AC guy. Yes, good hit. What do we got there? An assault, it looks like? No! Fuck! It's a shield lancer. That ain't good.
Looks like they called in some friends.
Alright, well the friends they called in are pretty far away. So I'm gonna go ahead and not worry about them right now. Let's just try to hold the line as best we can. DDT, we need... I hate to do this, but we're gonna use your second gas grenade right away.
I'm going.
We could also use the free frost pod. I don't know, though. I don't know if that's a good idea. Is this gonna hit that? Yeah, it is. What do we want to get here? We can get these three guys, and I feel like that's probably a good idea. I wish I could get the Muton as well, but I don't think we can. If we... oh, there's another Muton back here. God damn. We're at Muton Hill right now. Can we get this shield lancer? The faster we kill the shield lancer, the better off we are. Because everybody's got shields right now, and obviously that's a huge impediment to our success. Come on, get in there. There we go. I think he's highlighted now. So we'll get the fire breather, another Muton, and shield lancer.
Throwing a grenade.
DDT's behind full cover. Hopefully she'll be okay back there. And the shield lancer's down to 7 out of 8 health, has no armor and no shield left. Didn't get that Muton back here like I thought it would, though. That sucks. Skatewitch, you can get the Firestarter pretty nicely. You can also get this Muton, which... I don't know why you're... I guess he's behind a rock. I thought you were flanking him, but apparently not. You have a pretty good chance of actually just straight up killing this Muton. So, 6 to 8 damage. Okay, hold on. God damn it. four health, two armor, and three shields, so that's 9. So you need to do 9 damage total to actually kill him, which sucks. We can give you a 55% chance to crit. Yeah, I say go for it. Okay, not what we needed.
It hit the plate!
Yeah. But his shield's gone too. This is not great stuff. Other side, definitely light up the fire starter. We'll try and make this guy your job. Your little pet project. Kill the fire starter. Oh! Okay.
That's right.
Alright. Good work on your pet project. We've already used your running gun, unfortunately. I'm wary of bringing you up too close to anyone, frankly. But if I put you here, you'll have shots on quite a few guys, actually. I don't know why you won't have a flanking shot on this dude. You should. Let's see what you see from up here. Hopefully not another pod, which I didn't even think of. And sounds like that's happening. Fuck. Oh, goddammit. Those are snakes. That was... Let's hope that didn't doom us. Son of a bitch. Look at all these vipers you have great shots on, huh? See if you can kill that muton down there. With your axe. Good. What? How? I don't know why that's only a 57% chance, honestly. That's really sucky. None of these are good shots with rapid fire. Let's leave Seahorse there for now. Just ignore her pain and misery. And, if you go into overdrive, Seabass... Actually, if Seabass can distract snakes, they won't be able to bind or poison. As crazy as that sounds. Oh, I don't know. I've also got that bastard codex back there. Who can use skull mine? Oh, nice. Oh, but there's poison here. Is this gonna poison you? It might not, actually. I think all the poison is pretty much up here. Up on the top. So you might be okay if you do this, son of Dan Hinge. Except that you will get attacked by the mutons afterwards. You won't be okay in that sense. Wait, this is pretty rough. I think that we are clearly not doing ourselves any favor by keeping Grum out of concealment. So let's move him over here.
Moving out.
And then get ready to fire. Oh, we can only see this asshole. God damn it. What else have you got, Grum? You got a grenade. Which will not hit. Son of a bitch. I would also love for Seahorse to be able to attack with her flesh, but don't ever attack a muton with a melee attack. That's the rule. Sorry guys, I know this can't be thrilling to watch. I agonize over what to do. I had any kind of decent shots on these guys, I really do. Okay. I think what's gonna have to happen is we're just gonna have to start using explosives right away to, to clear out some of this cover.
Do not mar the Brotherhood's name any further.
And bombard back here. It hurts to use all our explosives this soon. Just really, we can't have these mutons around. They're gonna be a fucking disaster for us. That Stunlancer's poisoned, and these shields are down. Once the Stunlancer goes down, this set of shields will go down too. So I'm actually not too worried about killing the Stunlancer, because he's gonna die. Period. So, Son of Danhenge.
Reloaded!
You don't have a lot of shots. See what you can do to this muton. Fuck, man.
Deflection!
Can't
got
kill
no
him.
Ammo.
Percent, 72%. Ooh, that's really the one you gotta take though, because he's got so much fucking health. Yes! We're wearing him down. You know, that's good. Kwaisi guy, if you can hit this muton, it would be magic. Nice, nice! Kwai!
What did you expect?
I didn't expect that. Okay, and CC, I think, does not stand a very good chance of getting that muton back there. Oh, he'll be able to see him from here. So we can pray. 55. Just try. Howard. Oh my god, guys. Rookies.
People tend to underestimate me.
I guess so. Okay, great. I think we could try and get Seahorse into some really good cover here. I'm a little worried about Skatewitch. TVQH. Who can you see, Skatewitch? That Codex. Oh no, that Viper all the way back there. Yeah, I am worried about Seahorse. Let's get her all the way back here.
Come on!
We're gonna lose sight on that pod back there. It's soon to be two pods. But she there was nothing she could do up there. Okay, Trenchfoot, your job, we still have a muton on the map, so your job will be to keep that muton down as best you can.
Moving to position!
No, don't suppress the guy with one health who's poisoned.
Suppressing fire on target!
Grum, you're still in concealment. And Seabass, you're done. Your turn's done. Nice! That should mean the shields go. Excellent.
Getting crowded over here.
Oh, fucking more codices. Sounds like a mech, too. Alright, we got snakes. Mech. Oh my god. Oh my god. Right, please shoot. Just shoot. Just shoot. Fuck you.
Might be poison here.
Well, this is some shit, huh? Oh, don't you dare. Whew. Okay, I don't know how you saw Skatewitch from there. Unsurprisingly, being poisoned means that his reaction shot for suppression sucked ass.
This looks a little ugly!
Okay, great, yeah. Awesome. Do you not have a flashbang? I thought I gave you a flashbang. Apparently I gave you an EMP. Do EMPs hurt codices? I feel like they should. Yeah, I should probably save it for a mech anyway. Let's just get you out of here.
I'm on it!
Oh, right.
They got me!
Yeah, they did. Yep, they got you. And you're still in the field of poison, I guess, actually. Yeah, it sucks. Trenchfoot, you definitely have a flashbang. I just gotta put you somewhere. Okay, CBS needs to make cover.
Sensors online.
Nice. Awesome. All right, that should power up Seabass's gun too, right? Right? Twice. Beauteous. Not that he can do much about it. He's got to reload.
Shall I resume operation?
Okay. DDT is. I think we had her grenades. And she is inside of the death cloud. So we're
okay,
back here.
Moving out.
You. Here we go. Sting grenade. Yeah, that's what we like. Sting grenade has a small chance of stun.
Grenade out!
Beautiful. Did 2 damage to that snake, too. And stunned the snake. Awesome! We put you here. You have flanking shot on that codex. Do it.
Right.
Yep. Rapid fire. I'm just tickled pink by your killing power, Seahorse.
Yeah, what's that?
Back over here.
Okay, other side. I really want to be able to put you in a position where you're going to see someone. And I think that means I'm going to move you all the way over to this tree.
On my way.
And then you're going to have a very unlikely shot on a mutant. I mean, not super unlikely, but pretty unlikely. We'll hold off to see if that opens up for some reason. Which it may, because ZC is going to die. No offense, ZC, but you're poisoned, and you only have 4 health. So you're gonna do everybody a favor.
Descend now.
And go down like a hero. Freeing up that cover. Did it actually free up the cover? Yeah, now we got a 90% shot. Just don't miss, please. Other side.
Went off the armor!
Okay, he's not, still not quite dead. But he's doing much worse than he was. How do we wanna play this escape which I really don't know. Let's hold off on that for now. Oh fuck, you don't have combat protocol because you're green. Alright, we'll use your aid protocol later.
Heading out!
You're being flanked, aren't you? Yeah, that was bad. It was a bad choice. If we get Grum here... No. Wait. Yes, if we get Grum... Can't see shit. If we get Grum into this half... Into this full cover... No, he can't see the, mutant. The thing that really sucks about this mutant is that he's, like, practically fucking invisible. Back there. Seriously? I can't even see him from up here. Alright, Grum, just get up there. As long as I have Grum up here, since I'm pretty sure there's a mech somewhere here, they have Bombard. I don't actually want to reveal him now. Man, I wish I had fucking... You can't. You're not going to be able to hit a goddamn thing. Oh, and again, you're flanked.
Moving to position.
I really wish there was somewhere I could move Skate Witch so that he would see this mutant. But there does not appear to be such a place on this earth. And he is being flanked. by the goddamn dude over there. Oh, sucks. Escape, which I have no idea what to do with you. Who else we got? Dan Hinge. Got Quiet Sea Guy. I can move him into certain death. That sounds like fun. A 5% shot on a stunned viper. You know what? Whatever, just take it. Might hit him. Might not.
That is not good.
Running drive.
Grum just hunkered down.
Covering.
Dan Hench. You're gonna use aid protocol on Seabass. Skatewitch.
Is it clear?
Skatewitch caused the stunned snake to panic. Makes a lot of sense to me. Yeah, why not? See if you can do frostbite on that viper back there. It would, oh, awesome. Alright, that takes pressure off of
just
us
a little off.
On this next turn. That's really great. What do you mean just a little off? You hit him, you froze him. Don't be dumb, Skatewitch. Don't be dumb. Tempted to have you hunker down. But as long as you can do damage, you should. Oh, awesome. Alright, Skatewitch the unexpectedly useful. Considering his horrible positioning. Really? You missed CC. Good work. You're gonna shoot him now, though. I guarantee you. Yeah, rip. Hate that snake. Seahorse taking cover next. Oh, beautiful. He's burning. Oh, fuck. No, 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 no. No, no, no. Oh, what? Who? Oh, because he's burning, so his aim sucks. Oh, beautiful. Don't you fucking move. Oh, they're all going on Overwatch back there. Good. I don't give a shit. How can you... What is that?
I'll kill you, you fucker.
Oh, shit. Okay, well, good. Yeah, because the mech cannot see Grum up there, so he's not going to bombard him.
More of them coming in!
Shit. Ah. This is not a good time.
Alright, that one hurt!
I bet it did. Okay. TDT, who do you see? You see this Muton back here. Can you... If I move you up here, do you think you can
take care of it?
Reload. Oh shit, your primary weapon. God damn it. Well, no, you can't take care of anything now.
Reloading this thing.
Who is gonna take care of this Muton? That's poison. That's our fault. Trenchfoot, you have a 4% shot because you're poisoned. Kawhi, you actually can see from back here. You killed one Muton. This one, I think, has too much health for you to do it, but good shot. Or not. Unbelievable. Unfucking believable, man.
By the numbers.
Okay. Let's keep going. Yeah, you can't see anybody. Seabass, if we move you up to this window...
Affirmative.
Oh, you may get shot at by a mech. Nope, you didn't. Good. We got this strong box, advanced stock, okay, and another core. That's good stuff. And you can only see the Viper. That's interesting. So if we move Butler's side up behind Seabass, he will also only be able to see the Viper. Additionally interesting. Huh.
Heading out.
I mean, it'd be nice to take the Viper down. Honestly. Did that do it? No, it's got one health. Motherfucker. Might as well take this opportunity to get Skate Witch into a place where he needs to be. Oh, he's gonna get spotted by that fucking Muton right away. I'm stupid. Oh no, no, wait, we killed the Muton. What am I saying? What am I saying? Okay. Seahorse. You do not have running gun yet. Shit. That's not gonna be a good shot. No, these are not good shots at all. If I move you up here, you will trigger the overwatch of the mech.
Alright, come on.
Good. And 87 on the frozen Viper and 86 on the mech. I say go for the mech. Ah, close. Okay.
Need ammo.
Well, you're gonna get poisoned again, you son of a bitch. But let's move you here.
On your order.
We're gonna lose another specialist.
I think you poisoned me.
And this is why we bring EMP grenades, so that we can't throw them far enough mysteriously. What the fuck? We were able to throw. Oh. Okay. Yeah. Whatever. Hit the codex. I don't want to have to deal with him. Her. Is it just me, or is it kind of pathetic that an EMP grenade only does 6 damage to a codex? I feel like that sucks. Yeah, please reload. And, just, I don't know, go on Overwatch. There's not much
locked
you're gonna
and loaded.
Do.
Overwatch.
Same for you, Seabass. Oh, Brucey.
Very well.
You're gonna die.
No time to run, coward!
I really want to get Grum in on this action, but we just have not had good shots, you know? But he could take out this mech. He stands a very good chance of taking out that mech. Can't throw around this box. Oh, do we do it? Do we do it? I think we do it. God damn it! God damn it! Oh, that's bad. Hey, you hit. Good work, Brucey. Dan Ange is going down. You fucking poisonous. Oh my god. Oh, why is Grum marked? How does that work? This is going pretty badly. Oh, Jesus. 13% chance, and it hit. I can't believe these boxes are holding up. You're gonna nade him. Or you're not. You're just gonna shoot him. Which so far I'm gonna say is fine, because he's still not dead. Ooh. Goddamn snakes, you are gonna bind.
Somebody give me some fucking aspirin.
How we doing? Our turn yet?
I might need some help. I need a med kit here. I think they got me.
Ooh, doggies. DDT is in very bad shape here. She is getting flanked by all of these guys. Okay. I think people are not going to be a fan of this decision, but I'm going to make a judgment call, which is that we are losing. And I'm going to say we got to get the fuck out of Dodge, or we're going to die. That's just kind of how it goes. So this means we will lose this region. Bad news just continues for WDDPCOM.
On my way.
It's just a bad news party. Can we kill people before we go? Of course we can. Never said we couldn't kill people before we leave.
I hope you rot.
Get in there. You will not be able to shoot anyone. What about Skate Witch, who is in concealment, weirdly? Put you here, you'll have a shot on that codex.
Alright, I'll go! I'm spotted.
You don't have good shots because you're poisoned, though. So, whatever, just take a shot. I don't give a shit. Weird.
Shot wide.
Okay. Other side. Get in there too.
Sure thing.
And you're also poisoned and have almost no ammo, but you can do this.
Here, catch!
And everybody will enjoy that. Okay. Seabass, you can slide on in. Put your arms around me. See if you can free up Son of Danhedge. I have a bad feeling that Son of Danhedge won't be able to make it back, though. Oh, he will. That's kind of incredible. Alright, Son of Danhedge lives.
Already there!
I feel, you know, this would have gone probably okay if we hadn't gotten the Haven defense. We're just not, I mean, at this stage, we're just not ready for that shit. Yeah, come on, get in there.
Affirmative!
Yeah, why not? You too, Clone of Aquasi. Well, guy, you killed, what, two mutants? It's pretty good. I have a bad feeling, though, that Brucey is dead. Gonna go with yes, definitely. Yeah, there's no way he's gonna live. That's just craziness. Well, put him there. Give him a chance to run. Alright, everybody out!
Alright, alright!
The inglorious escape.
Heading home.
Have we made things too difficult?
Just in time.
Nah. It's the children who are wrong. Wait. Seahorse, you have a grenade? Yeah, you do. Fuck you, Mech.
I had my doubts about you guys. Not anymore.
Really? Because we're losing this.
We are victorious.
Oh, you guys have a real strange idea of victory. I mean, not having our specialist die is a kind of victory.
Just in time! Evac confirmed.
Oh, we have another rookie here too. Beeps. That's funny. Oh, you guys aren't gonna
make
it.
How much further?
I'm sorry. Oh shit, Grum's still up here. How could I have forgotten about Grum?
Heading out.
Grum took quite a bit of damage. Killed a snake.
Only the best. I'm out of here.
Ah, we don't get any of these corpses either. That sucks. Ooh, here comes death.
No. Not yet.
Quite a death cry. What are you gonna do, shoot me? Yes. Okay, that codex with the flaming hair, apparently, seems to mark targets when it shoots at them. Which is just, like, what the fuck, Derby K is the author of Better Admin. That's just bullshit, man. That's just a shitty thing to do. Oh, this guy's gonna kill Brucey.
Yep.
All surviving XCOM operatives are secure. Firebrand returning to base.
Commander, we failed in our mission. We'll need to review our tactics and improve going forward.
RIP. Well, I think it's clear now that the A-Team is not invincible. Seahorse dealt the most damage. The rookie clone Quai-C-Guy made the most attacks. Grum was most under fire. There was that ridiculous turn where everyone was shooting at him. And Seahorse moved the furthest. We had some really great shots there, but we were just totally fucking overwhelmed. Like, just the expanded pod size plus the brutality of the pod composition for Better Advent. That was never going to go well, really. Looking good. Almost no promotions. Skatewitch got a promotion. Let's see, steady hands. If you do not move last turn, gain plus 10 aim and plus 10 critical chance. That's a good one. Clutch shot. Once a promotion, fire pistol shot that can't miss. Kind of already have that with your shadow thing. And Kubikiri is a really strange perk. So any critical hit you does kills the target, but regular hits only do half damage. It requires both of your actions, and it has a cooldown. So if you can guarantee a critical hit, like pretty much, or you know, have a really good chance of a critical hit, you can outright kill a target. And that's sort of fascinating, but you get punished for not having, you know, if the critical hit is not successful. And the way we constructed Skatewitch so far, and his sniper rifle doesn't have laser sight or anything like that. And especially with squad sight, there's detriments to critical hits. So I think we're going to go conservative and just stick with steady hands. Because on a good day, Skatewitch doesn't move that much. So he'll always have that bonus. Okay, Trenchfoot, you didn't really get the chance to shine here because you got hit with poison right away and then just sort of danced around without ammunition. Hail of bullets, guaranteed to hit your target, but uses a lot of ammo. That might actually be useful to us since you're getting what are those? The EMP rounds or blue screen rounds? But danger zone increases suppression radius. That's pretty good too. I don't usually get hail of bullets, so let's get it this time. Did I get that from Indy too? I can't remember. I feel like I keep doing things I don't usually do just for, you know, see how it goes, and then I can't remember how many times I do that. Okay, you're confident that you can kill aliens, that's good. I believe this is combat protocol back here. And you're definitely gonna learn that, and congratulations on not dying. We got a codex brain out of that despite fleeing from the scene. I don't know how that works, but whatever.
Hello, Commander.
Okay, so our monthly income went down by 50. We lost contact with that region, and it'll take more time to recontact them. Whoo, guys! Things are bleak. See you next time on WDDPCOM!